met you on my very first TV show. Do you remember?
You don't remember? You were a chicken and you appeared naked. I want to show everybody, we've made a little montage of what Paul has been doing throughout this series. So would you please explain what you've been doing?
I've been working with people who you gave me who are phobic, people who are claustrophobic, agoraphobic.
Because I'm good to you.
And people who have had unusual phobias. There was a gentleman who had a phobia of rubber. And what I've been doing is we've been thinking of extreme ways of demonstrating these people are cured.
Is that what makes you crazy?
All right, stop that.
All right.
How close can the balloons get before you start?
Balloons are the worst. They really are the worst.
Right. And what is it? Is it just that they're floating?
Rubber.
Your hands sweat?
Yep.
And does your heart go?
Yep.
You can never hold a string.
No.
So you want to get over your fear of public speaking, so, you know, your social phobia, if you like.
Yeah.
But turn and look at all the people, right? That feels quite scary, doesn't it?
Or is it?
Yeah. Yeah. But if you were to try and even talk to them, on a scale of 1 to 100, where's the fear?
It's horrible, right?
Have you ever been in a room in 33 years by yourself?
No.
Never?
Not in a trapped room, no.
On a scale of 1 to 100, how scared are you of getting in this box right now?
Don't ask.
Whether we can get these guys to be as good as professional performers, I don't know, but I can certainly get it so that you can be more comfortable in your own skin and you don't have the fear there.
Imagine getting inside that coffin and closing the lid. And it's dark inside. Can't get out. Want to get out.
Bring it closer. It's all right. We're not going to
keep it going up. Keep it going up. What number is it at now?
Count backwards in your mind. From 300. Whoosh, 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 whoosh. Now, think about getting in the coffin, thinking about closing the lid.
You are strong. You are strong like bull.
See what you'll see, hear what you'll hear, feel how good you feel. Oh, that's brilliant. That's good.
Let's do the big test. Bring out the balloons.
Now what I do, I'm going to make these silks change colour. Now what colour would you like them to be? Can you shout a colour out?
Pink.
Pink. How about it, invisible?
Would you allow the lovely dentist to open your mouth and put this in your mouth? All right, go. That's unbelievable.
You look surprised that I copped off with someone. I'm in shape. Okay, it's not the right shape, but granted, but anyway.
Well, you look out there, is there something you want to say to the audience?
I'm Melanie. Before I came here today, I was a nervous wreck.
I light up when you call my name, and you know you're gonna treat you right. You give me fever.
All right, Pauline, so how are you feeling now? You okay?
Yeah, fine.
Right, now, here we go. We've got a camera inside the coffin, so we'll be able to see Pauline on the monitor. There we go. Right now.
She can't get out?
She can't get out. Do you want to come out?
No, Mum.
All right, we'll leave her in here.
Yeah.
And this is the lady who you hammered
into the coffin,
and a strange thing to do, I have to say. I mean, did you, in the coffin when you were in there, did you think, I think I might lose my mind?
No.
You just have total faith in him?
Mm.
And you haven't left your house before this show. You hadn't left your house alone for 33 years. And so when you go to a shop, she'd always have to have somebody with her. So what did you do when you left the show?
The first thing I did is went over the off license and bought myself a bottle of wine.
Alone?
Alone.
You soloed it?
Soloed it.
Yeah.
I've been to the station and drove to the station to pick my friends up.
Alone?
Alone.
Very good.
And now I go to the shops, only the local shops.
Right.
And I say I'm going to the shops and my son gets ready to put his coat on because he's always come with me. I say no. I'm going on my own. And they go, oh, all right.
Do you think you might be able to go on an airplane? Because she's
hopefully
never gone on a holiday with her family. They used to have to send her videos back.
Yeah.
I'll bet you do.
Hopefully.
I'll bet you do.
You will do. You will. The thing is that to suddenly change everything overnight might be a bit too much because of the way your life's been arranged. But if you look at it, the old phobia is collapsing away. And so within a short space, I had a lady write to me the other day who'd same sort of condition as you. And it was only a few weeks before she got on a plane on her own, went to Australia, and then came back
again.
Can
you get somebody to Australia without a plane? Just by
I'm working on it.
I want to know how far this one goes. Can you teach me to fly? Now, this lady never went to a dentist, and now, and was missing teeth, has had a filling done,
mm-hmm.
and there was no fear. Were you apprehensive when you went to the dentist?
I was a little bit uncomfortable, but no more so than I think normal people would be at a dentist. But I went on my own, had the treatment, and it's great.
It's a miracle.
It is. It's an absolute miracle.
Now, where's your boyfriend? Melanie? There's your boyfriend. You had to be with Melanie all the time when she wouldn't pick up a telephone?
No, she always used to panic, anything like that.
And when she left this studio, was it a different woman?
Oh, completely, yeah. We went over the pub, she was straight up to the bar, demanding service.
Right.
So I'd like to thank her.
Or when it was midnight on New Year's Eve, you'd have to wait outside when the balloons...
Yeah, go and sit in the car every New Year's Eve. Mm. So the balloons didn't touch me.
So now, when you left the show...
Everyone made me touch rubber gloves.
They do that to me, yeah. Too.
Then my son brought a tray with little rubber toys on and made me touch one individually.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Was he excited that you could do that now?
Yeah, very excited.
Can you do everything now to do with rubber? I mean, can you touch it, smell it, eat it? Blow it up? Can you blow up the balloon?
Yeah.
You haven't blown up a balloon yet?
It's the first... I mean, 28 years I haven't blown a balloon up for. So.
28 years?
Yeah.
Do you think you can do it, Paul?
I got a balloon here, actually.
All right.
Here we go. Let's
see if he can blow that balloon.
Here we go.
Does this make you nervous?
No, it just makes me nervous that I might not be able to blow up because I haven't blown one up.
So copy me, yeah? So grip it tight there, yeah? Okay, yep. Let's give it a little stretch like
if people
that.
People are tuning in now. It's really important you know what we're doing here. He's afraid of blowing up balloons. He's now conquering his fear, and there he goes! Yes!
Fantastic!
Thank you all for coming on the show.
Thank you.
Thank you.